be a big fight, you know what I mean? I would love to fight Charlo. He says he can knock me out, but I got power to knock his ass out too, so whenever he wants. I think it would be a great fight. I think people would love to see that fight, so I'm all for it.
Yo, yeah, so hey, Charlo, if you're watching this, I know you did an interview, say you would knock David out. Hey, man, I think that would be an easy fight to make. You want to fight, we want to fight. Fuck Caleb Plant, fuck Canelo, you know? Let's make the fight happen. You got balls, we got balls, let's make it happen.
These fighters, they just need to fucking grow a pair of balls and just get in there. I'll fight whoever.
For David, you know, he's a two-time world champ, you know? He was the youngest world champion in history. Now I hear that Canelo doesn't want to fight Mexicans. I mean, like, yeah, he didn't want to fight for the WBC when David had it. He didn't want nothing to do with the 168, but as soon as David left that belt, he jumped in right away, and now he doesn't want to fight Mexicans. I don't think he wants to fight David. Maybe if David goes up to 175 that he's not doing, then he'll come back and fight the Mexicans again. But I think the problem right now, he just feels that people are pressuring him to fight David, you know? But that's the five fighters that we would love to fight.
So David Benavidez starting off the year with a bang by accepting Jermall Charlo fight challenge, in which he stated, and I quote, "We can make it happen in September if you are really about it at Future of Boxing," end of the quote. These aren't just fighting words. These are let's make a fight type of words, because David Benavidez put a date on it, and it's fair to say there isn't more of a deserving date than Mexican Independence Day on September for such a mega fight between two warriors. If someone is gonna challenge a lion, it's definitely going to take another lion like the Benavidez of the world. Therefore, this is great news for the sport of boxing, especially after I've been giving you guys bad news literally every other day, thanks to the Ryan, Canelo, and the Teofimo NBF takeover, who promised Mike Tyson they're going to fight so-and-so, and literally the next day, they break their promise. However, when it comes to David Benavidez, he cut different. He's cut from that old school fabric. However, he happens to be around these new school type of fighters, the likes of Canelo Alvarez, the cheaters of the world, who claims he runs the jungle by eating contaminated meat so he could run faster from the predators such as the lions, then turn around and claims he's the king of the jungle. Why? Because he runs the jungle by maneuvering, dancing around the best competition, the likes of Benavidez and Jermall Charlo. However, he prefers the likes of Avinis. Therefore, apparently both Benavidez and Jermall Charlo came to a realization that when it comes to Canelo Alvarez, it's not just NBF, since he's the pioneer of the WBC franchise witness program, in which Canelo Alvarez requested for witness protection as soon as Jermall Charlo became his mandatory, in which Canelo elected to get stripped and surrender his WBC pride to Jermall Charlo, all to avoid to be forced to hop into the lion's den where Jermall Charlo happens to be. Therefore, the cheater went hunting, eating some more contaminated meat in order to find another territory that's easier to conquer. And then when he moved up to 168, he wanted no part of Benavidez. Why? Because when it comes to Canelo Alvarez, it's not just NBF, it's also no undefeated Mexican fighters, NMF. Where literally Canelo Alvarez said it out of his own mouth as soon as he moved up to the 168 pounds. But it's ironic to me, because Canelo Alvarez fought the likes of Chavez Jr., Lopez, Angulo. I guess Canelo didn't get the memo that he already fought Mexican fighters before. But now all of a sudden, he neglected giving the fans the legendary classic wars, the Barrera Morales Marquez, when he saw Benavidez. But as soon as Benavidez miscalculated his weight and got stripped of his belt, he called Suleiman in no time. And just like he requested the witness protection from the NBF franchise program, he also requested to fight for the WBC vacant title against Iovine, a fighter coming off a loss and 2-year layoff. So instead of activating the franchise designation in order to avoid an unnecessary mandatory the same way he did with Jermall Charlo, he elected to fight Iovine. Matter of fact, he requested to fight Iovine because it never been about unnecessary mandatories. It's actually the other way around. The purpose of the franchise designation is to kill any mega fight and order witness protection in order to eliminate any threat. Because since Canelo Alvarez have the complexion for the connection to get the ultimate protection, he figured he could run the jungle two different ways. Either fight everybody and be the king of the jungle, like the lion, and hop into the lion's den with Charlo and Benavidez, or be a cheetah and run the jungle that way. By choosing to fight a fighter coming off a loss and a 2-year layoff, or fighting a guy in a 4-week notice, so on and so forth. And it's not a secret what Canelo chose to do. That's why Canelo Alvarez is fighting for Benavidez belt against Iovine, who's coming off a loss that Canelo requested himself. That's why Canelo Alvarez will always be remembered as the pound for pound number one against Europe. He's Europe pound for pound number one because he said he won't fight any undefeated Mexican fighters, and he sure won't fight any undefeated black fighters. At 154, he avoided Jermall Charlo and Andrade. At 160, he avoided both Jermall Charlo and Andrade. And now at 168, he's avoiding Benavidez, acting like Benavidez does not even exist. And that's why the most avoided fighter at 168, the best 168 pounder, Benavidez, who happened to be the boogeyman at 168, that called out everybody from Ramirez to Caleb Plant to Caleb Smith, even Berlinga. Benavidez want all of the smoke. Now he accepted Jermall Charlo challenge, one of the most feared 160 pounders that put fear in the likes of Gennady Golovkin and Canelo Alvarez, who's a top 10 pound for pound fighter. Like I said before, it's going to take a lion to challenge another lion. You definitely can't expect a cheetah to hop into the lion's den. Therefore, there is no faith in Canelo, since he avoided both of these two young lions. However, one fighter that's bringing that old school feel back, the Barrera Morales of our time, Benavidez, he's willing to do that. And guess what? Charlo and Benavidez most likely fight for no title, while Canelo Alvarez fights Iovine for their title. But guess what? It's not about the title, because the winner of Benavidez versus Charlo will be more of a champion, even without a title, than the winner of Canelo versus Iovine with the title. See, the way Benavidez and Charlo carry themselves, hate them or love them, they are the champions of the people, with or without the title. As far as I know, Canelo could have a diamond belt, literally made from diamonds, and Benavidez will still be more of a champion than he is, because he's willing to face all comers. So I gotta give Benavidez a lot of credit and props for accepting Jermall Charlo challenge in order to give the fans the fights We want to see, in my humble opinion, whoever loses this fight won't be a big deal. Because for each fighter, Benavidez and Charlo, this is their biggest challenge. On the other hand, the winner of this fight will put himself in a great position to be the face of the division, in which Canelo Alvarez won't be able to maneuver around for too long. I can't promise that Canelo will fight the winner, but I can promise you Canelo will look like a coward to continue to avoid these two. Last but not least, Benavidez have a fight in March coming up. We can't wait to see it. I'm going to try to get Benavidez on split decision, as well as Jermall Charlo, as he too should have another fight against Eubanks, for example, who will be a perfect tune-up for Benavidez, since Eubanks have a lot of hand speed and he's very athletic as well. So that will be a great fight for Charlo to have in April or around there. In the meantime, they could both agree to fight each other next in September. That way, we could start promoting the fight right now. Why not lock the date right now? Because definitely Canelo does not deserve to fight on that date. This fight is more deserving. This fight will be a gift to all of the fans around the world. With all of that being stated, we're going to definitely talk more so about this fight in particular on Split Decision and what Benavidez Sr. had to say about Charlo and Canelo Alvarez, including what David Benavidez had to say. Therefore, drop your thoughts in the comment section below, subscribe below, and click on the notification bell to be continued on the next episode of Aki TV. Peace, and we out here.